I've got something fresh. You guys should appreciate this. Years ago, when I was 16, in high school. Live in not quite a city, more like an old town that expanded more than it could really support. Decent amount of run-down and abandoned buildings. Get into a kind of urban exploration kick, sneaking into places and checking them out. Occasionally engage in minor looting, sometimes you find neat stuff. Manage to talk a few friends into coming with me sometimes, but only three are relevant for this story. One was an old buddy of mine who I'll be calling Bill, and another was a girl I had a minor crush on who I'll call Susan. The last one is the most important. He told us his name was Eli, and there's probably not much point in censoring anything for him. Bill, Susan and I all went to the same school, but I met Eli while I was checking out some old restaurant. Spooked the hell out of me because I had just snuck in through a window and he speaks up from right fucking behind me. He thought it was funny as hell. We get to talking, I tell him about my hobby and ask if he's doing something similar. Yeah, more or less. I like to keep an eye out for unusual things. Or things that don't belong. Okay. Seems kinda weird, but he's friendly, and I'm running around scavenging junk in a half-wrecked diner or whatever so I can't talk. We chat for a bit, turns out Eli doesn't go to my school, which explains why I've never seen him around before. He listens more than he talks, and doesn't volunteer much info about himself, but I don't want to pry too much and he seems alright. We clamber back out, I startle a cat that was sitting by the window. Eli pets it before it runs off. Part on good terms, a week or so later, I'm hanging out with Bill, showing him this old three-story apartment building or motel or something. Planning the expedition like we're getting away with the heist of the century. Suddenly. Still exploring? Jesus fuck, Eli from behind me again. Bill actually jumps and I laugh at him like I hadn't nearly soiled myself. Introduce the two, they seem to hit it off well enough. Ask Eli if he wants to come with us to explore the place Friday night. He just kinda looks at me for a second, then tilts his head and stares at the building. Good 10 seconds of silence. Yeah. Might be a good idea. Neat. Friday night rolls around. I manage to talk Susan into coming with us, so it's me, Bill and her. And Eli, when he finally shows up. I'm watching this time, you bastard. Not again. He casually strolls down the street in plain view with his hands in his pockets. He's grinning at me, he knows I was expecting another jump scare. Whatever, I introduce him to Susan, we're all friends now, let's rock. So it's about 7 p.m., still got some light out, we're standing outside the place. Building is kind of dilapidated and boarded up but shouldn't be too dangerous to wander around in and we've all got flashlights. Also apparently a nesting ground for stray cats because I can see three of them sitting in what was probably an old flower bed or something and another just darted under the front steps. The front's still locked up, but there's a side door that doesn't properly close anymore. It looks like it used to be boarded up, but that had rotted off. I may have helped it along. So we enter the building. This was a bad idea. The place is mostly normal. Old, dirty, has that slight moldy decrepit wreck smell all abandoned places tend to have. We wander around the ground floor a bit, nothing really interesting, it's mostly just a lobby. Figure we might find something more interesting on the second or third floors, that's where the rooms are. The three of us are joking around, but Eli's pretty quiet. Whenever we go into a room he'd just kinda stare into it from the doorway then pace around the walls. Whatever works for him, I guess. The rooms are all empty though, guess they cleared the place out pretty good when they left it. Only thing we saw was a few more cats darting down the halls. We look around for maybe 30 minutes before deciding to call it quits. Not a bad time, But I'm a little disappointed we didn't find someone's old luggage full of plus-size ballerina outfits or something. So we head down the stairs. And keep going down the stairs. Conversation peters off. Why are there so many steps here? Did we get turned around and go down the wrong stairwell somehow? Maybe we're coming out at the basement. Starting to smell kinda funky, probably some nasty mold down there. But there's the door, so let's see where it goes. Eli hasn't said anything for the last 10 minutes. Turns out to be another hallway of rooms. The four of us are standing by the stairwell looking down the hall. Kinda confused, subterranean apartments are kind of an odd choice. We decide to go back up and find the right stairs again. Eli is at the base of stairs, looking up. I ask him what's up and look where he's looking. Something is standing at the top of the alcove. My first reaction is that we're about to get shanked by a drunken homeless man. Then things start registering. It's big, but kind of squashed and wide, like if a person was stretched out from the sides, and its legs are even more disproportionately short and stumpy. What I thought was a really grimy coat is actually long, tangled, really ratty-looking hair or fur covering its body. Can't even see any eyes, just hair. There's a mouth though. I can tell because it starts screaming at us. The mouth is too wide, it looks like it starts on the side of its head, and there aren't any teeth, just the clips and spittle. I almost would have preferred shark teeth or something, there was just something really revolting about the gaping, empty mouth. The noise itself was just fucking terrifying. I can't even describe it other than to say it's not a sound that a person could make. Like it went into my ear and started throttling the caveman part of your brain that identifies threats. It started to stagger down towards us, still screaming. We were all screaming. Except Eli, who was shoving me back into the hallway and manhandling the others into running. We didn't need much encouragement. We're sprinting as fast as we fucking can down a dark corridor with God knows what screeching behind us. It's not very fast, but we can hear it chasing us with uneven stomps. The flashlights help, but we're moving so spastically it's throwing crazy shadows all over the place, which does not help our state of mind. There's another stairwell on the other side of hall. If we can go back up, we can find the way out. Except it only goes down. There's no fucking up staircase, just a wall. Susan's sobbing by now, I'm not far off myself. Eli shoves us forward again so we don't stop moving, and we go down. The hallway down here goes forward a lot farther than the other floors. The ceiling is a lot higher than it seems it should be for how far down we went. That rancid smell from earlier is a lot worse. And we can hear the thing half tumbling down the stairs after us. I'm about to start running again when Eli sprints past us towards one of the doors and wrenches it open. In. It's safer. I guess we're hiding. No one argues. Probably because we're all still so freaked out we'll take even slightly helpful direction at this point. We run into the room. I almost freeze up because there's something in there with us. It's another cat. Eli's standing in front of the door, holding it closed. No one moves, no one even breathes. Hear the thing gurgle and scream and gallop towards our room. Then, from farther away, a loud, feline yowl. Then several more. The thing roars again and we hear it go past us. I'm looking at the cat sitting in the middle of the floor. It's staring at Eli. A few seconds go by, and he quietly opens the door again. The stairs are just fucking gone, it's hallway in both directions. One of us is making a high-pitched whimpering noise, I'm not sure who, but I wouldn't rule out any of us right now. Stressful doesn't quite cover it. The screaming's coming back. I think to go back into the room again, but Eli's already moving down the hall. The cat's following him. Susan goes after him. So does Bill. I hesitate by the first room for a second, torn between hiding in there again and making another run for it in the open. Decide I don't want to be alone more than I want to be in that room, and I run after them. I nearly freak the fuck out when something brushes my leg. It's another cat, running beside me. Not hurting me, just ignore it. Eli's ushering Susan and Bill into another room ahead of me. I see them hesitate for a second before entering. Eli's staring at me now, holding the door open. I hear the scream again. I run through the doorway and stumble to a stop as Eli closes it behind me. Bill and Susan are there. And so are the cats. Like, dozens of them. The room's full of them. Bill's just standing there, twitching, and I can hear him repeating fuck 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 very quietly. Susan's sitting on the floor half curled into a ball. There's a circle of cats standing around them, some of them are watching them but the others are staring out into the room. All the other cats are either stalking around or sitting and staring into space. Getting freaked out again, this is not normal behavior. Hey. And then there's Eli, who is much too calm for this situation, and has somehow acquired a platoon of disturbingly focused alley cats. Seriously, there's maybe six of them at his sides and his back following his steps. Stay here. You'll be okay. I'll make it stop. Too fucking panicked to question him. Also don't really know what the hell he's pulling with the cats and suddenly don't want him focusing on me. Susan proves she has bigger balls than me and manages to ask him what's happening. When he looks at her, so do all the cats following him, at the same time. What the fuck, Eli? Stay. You're safe with us. I'll come back. And then he walks out with his cat followers and closes the door behind him. The cats apparently left to guard us deliberately open a path for me to stand next to Bill and Susan. So I stand with them. They circle us again. Not sure how long we sat there, my sense of time was pretty screwed by then. Then, finally, there was a new sound. Except, I didn't really hear it, it was more like I could feel the vibration, like it was very, very loud but too low a pitch for me to hear. Made my hair stand on end and my whole body just locked up. Every damn cat is standing up and staring in the same direction. Ears back, tails down, eyes wide and huge and reflective. It stops after maybe half a minute, and the cats suddenly act like normal cats again. The ones circling us get up and wander around. A minute later, Eli abruptly walks back in. He looks fine, not a scratch on him. But he's lightly splattered with a disturbingly viscous pitch-black liquid, except for his right arm, which is coated up to the elbow with the stuff. I don't want to know, I do not want to know. The cats start filtering out the door. We can go now. I don't really have a lot of clarity for a bit afterwards. I vaguely remember walking, then running out of the building. Everything was normal again, the exit was easy to find. Bill booked it the second he was outside, no looking back. A couple cats followed him though. Susan and I stood outside with Eli for a few minutes. She tried asking him what happened again, but he just shrugged and said not to worry, he took care of it. If I wasn't still so terrified, I'd have been pissed at not getting an actual answer. We all went home, Eli walked back some of the way with me, Susan got another entourage of cats. We didn't talk about anything else, and when I could see my house I felt Eli pat me on the shoulder from behind. He was just gone when I turned around. When Susan and I talked about it a few days later, she swore he'd walked home with her and that I had walked off with a cat party. Needless to say, the urban exploration fucking stopped. We never saw Eli again. I looked around a little but I wasn't sure I wanted to find him. Susan did, though. Holy shit, did she want to find him. Pretty sure she put up missing person posters at some point. No luck though. Torpedoed any chance I had with her, Eli was all she talked about. Bill refused to discuss it at all. didn't even want to talk to me or Susan much, think he was trying to put as much distance between him and that night as possible. He picked up a drug habit a couple months afterwards, and from what little I got him to talk to me about it, he'd apparently retroactively decided that night was just a hallucination from bad weed or whatever. Despite him never having touched the stuff until well after everything went down, and all three of us having the same experience when I'd never taken drugs in my life, and Susan definitely hadn't. Self-delusion's a hell of a thing. Back in the present. Moved the hell out of that town. So did Bill. Susan's still there, we still talk semi-regularly. She works at an animal shelter. She owns three cats. I don't have any room to judge. When I was looking to move out to my own apartment, the first thing I asked the landlords was their policy on pets. I bought a cat the first day I moved in. Bill actually left the state entirely. Still won't acknowledge weird anything happened back then. We still don't talk much these days, but once when I spoke to him on the phone, he admitted that he keeps cats as well. Six of them. So to sum everything up, I was attacked by Eldritch Hobo Bigfoot, then rescued and cock-blocked by a magical cat boy. Thanks Eli. You son of a bitch. Thanks for 1K guys, I never thought I'd get to this point and I couldn't have done it without you guys.